In this video, we will talk about the past tense in Bosnian, Croatian, and Serbian. Similarly to the future tense, the past tense is a compound tense. It's structured from two separate building blocks. The first building blocks is the classic form of the verb biti, or to be, in present tense. So, biti in present tense is our first building block. So let's write it out. Ja, first person singular. Jesam. Ti. Jesi. On, ona, ono. Je. Mi. First person plural. Jesmo. Vi. Jeste. Oni. One. Ona. Jesu. Now, when I said classic form, that means that we need to get rid of something, make it shorter. What we'll get rid of is this prefix here, je. And what we'll get is following. Okay, so ja, sam, ti, si, on, ona, ono, je. And here you don't get rid of the first syllable. You keep it because there is nothing that follows it. Mi smo, vi ste, and then oni su. So this is the first building block. And the second building block that we need to create past tense is the past participle. Of the main verb. How do we get to the past participle? Well, we need to take the main verb. We'll use, say, čitati. And then we need to get rid of the infinitive suffix. And then we need to add some appropriate suffixes. Now, this portion of it, the past participle, is gendered, meaning that it gets gendered suffixes. So what you get is, depending on the gender of the subject, of the grammatical subject in the sentence, is either o, la, lo, in singular, and then li, le, or la in the plural. So masculine, feminine, neuter, singular. So let me write that out. Singular, plural, masculine, feminine, neuter. And then you just simply combine the two. So let's use it in a sentence so that I can show you how it works in practice. Let's use, let's say, ja, sam. And since I'm male, I will use singular, of course, because ja is first person singular. Masculine, past participle of the main verb čitao. Knjigu. I was reading a book. Ti, let's write out another example. Ti, si. And let's say that the subject here, the grammatical subject, is female. We'll use the feminine suffix in singular because ti is second person singular. So singular, feminine, čitala. Knjigu. You were reading a book. This is something that is extremely important when it comes to past tense. I can't emphasize how important it is to make sure that the gender of the grammatical subject is appropriately expressed by using the appropriate suffix of the six. So the easiest way to do this is to memorize these suffixes, because they're very easy and they never really change. And to understand how to construct the past participle using the suffixes, and then just use it in a very in this way that I have described. Now, there is a way to express yourself without having a direct subject in the sentence. As you know, BCS allows that. The way that it works is very similar to the future tense. You just need to get rid of the subject, in this case, ja or ti, and then reverse these two. So put the main verb in its auxiliary form, in its past participle form, sorry, here. Get rid of it here. And what you get is čitao sam knjigu. It is assumed that I, or the grammatical subject here, is a male speaker who was reading a book, just from this suffix and from the auxiliary verb here. Same thing in our example here. We will move the past participle to the beginning of the sentence. Čitala sam. We'll get rid of it here. Knjigu. It's still, you were reading a book. It's just expressed without the obvious, without the subject actually being in the sentence.